September 6, 2016, it's 9:06 a.m. It's a Tuesday. And just looking at how these tomatoes have been so decimated. You see a lot of this right here. I pulled off so many of these because of the fact of them like starting to turn like a brown spot. And between that and worms, you can see the bareness of the branches. This is one I put out here that was about this tall right here. Look at it, and I pulled off all them branches because they were diseased looking brown and about yellow spot. Now you got this, you can see the worms down there getting 5 or 6 of them off that looking like that right there. There's one still alive, I haven't cut up. I'm gonna videotape it too, or video record it. See, that's what we do to things that try to take our food from us. Anyway, see, look at this one. This one was so nice. This is the one that had 2 brown leaves on it. Just 2 brown leaves. It was smaller than this right here even. It was just 2 small brown leaves down there, and I started nourishing it back, and now look at it. Huh?
There's a big one.
Another big one? Wait, throw him down. Let's see him on the ground. What a bad joke this is.
Yeah, won't let go.
Where's he at? No, I can't get him out. Right, there he is. Ready? Ready? Sorry if that makes you sick to your stomach while people are killing one another. Killing pests. See, look, it's the first week of... Well, here's one. Can you get this one? Let me see him right there with the white... Oh, he's got... Is that eggs on him?
No.
What's this? White stripes?
It's just his stripes. Where are you going
right
here?
Right there.
If you let go of me.
Really trying to hang on to you. Oh, too late. Oh, I'm dead. But I was just going to say, see the tomato right here?
Oh, yeah.
If it'll focus. There's a tomato right there. There's 1 or 2 others on here. With the weather being like it is right now, it's possible to get probably about maybe 8 to 12 tomatoes on here. There's a tomato on here, but this one I think is diseased or insects. There's flowers on some of these. Seen butterflies out here. This one here, I was really hoping this one might put out a couple six tomatoes maybe before the end of the year, but look at just, you can see the leaves, but as long as you see these green leaves coming on the ends here, to me that means hope. That means that it's still alive and it's possible. Barring man God doing something where we have snow here in about 2 weeks or some bullshit. Yeah. It's frustrating to say the very least. I planted a black zucchini, black beauty zucchini down here. That one, for some reason, I'm really surprised. I should put 2 down. Black-eyed peas and purple hull peas are over here. Look at this. All the comments I get, too, none. But I say, you know, anybody know what this is, you know, I can use their suggestions or whatever you want to call it, their words. This is diseases, I'm guessing. You can see the purple hull peas right here, even. As they're turning on the vine. Black-eyed peas are mixed up there. I got the okra out back here. Still getting pods off those every day. That's a little small. Well, you can eat that, but it's a little small. I got this all strung up. I tore down these sunflowers right here, right up against these okra here. Those were the ones that just grew on their own from last year, so that's why I dropped them. I pulled them up and threw them out there. You rake some of these leaves. I gotta get them into a pile or something, you know. What I'll do is I'll rake them over here toward the end of the garden, number 3 garden here, and that way, because I usually try cutting around this garden with the mower, and that way I can just pile them up over there in the back corner.
Doesn't that look like marijuana leaves?
No. It's similar, but it's not. Yeah, no, they know better. And I go to jail for trying to kill some bullshit assholes just following orders. This is our livelihood, though. You know, it really is, because we're trying to get 85% of our food out of this garden. Did you get very many okra?
Yeah, quite a few.
Okay. See these?
I didn't pick them yesterday, so I got quite a few big ones.
Oh, okay. We got okra seeds, too. Lucy, go with Mommy. Go in the house. We got so many okra seeds, you know, we could probably plant this entire area out here. I mean, possibly all that field up to about where that pole is over there in the distance. Right there. That's about 1,500 feet away. We could plant all that with okra and have seeds left over. And well, it's fine. Like I said, I'd rather have more than not enough. I don't have a problem helping other people. We got butterflies out here still. These yellow ones. They must be doing their pollinating, because we've got about 12, 12 watermelon on this plant. Right there is a smaller one. There's some bigger than that one. That's about the size of a baseball right there. And like I say, there's one, let's see if I can get in there. Right there, you see that one in the center there? That's bigger than that's a lot bigger than a golf ball, even. And then there's one, I'm not gonna focus on every one, but there's like, let me zoom out. One, two, three, four, you can't really see that good in this video. Five, from this side, I can't touch. Six, over there is almost the size of a solid. Six, seven, eight. I don't know if those two are going to make that one. This is going to make it a bigger one. Eight. I don't think it will be the next week. Yeah, that's a pretty good size, but that's about almost like a small cantaloupe, but it's a watermelon. See, and I just let this go. You see the flowers on there, and you see the butterflies. So, look, there's a little melon on there, too. Let me zoom in and zoom out for it to focus. See a little green ball right there? That's a watermelon. But see the butterfly right there? We still have butterflies out here. There's a bee on there too. Wow, that's some first. I'm chasing that butterfly. Look at they're both good. Oh, I thought they were gonna work on the flower together. Guess not. So it's just sporadic, you know. A few bees. Now that I see that, well, actually one bee. Butterflies. Oh, see, there's another. Right down there. It's a little oblong, that one. This one might be a bad one too. I don't see it. I'll turn it off if it is bad. No, it's just odd shaped. There's that one right down there. So there's about 11 or 12 out here. I say that one right there we're not sure about, because it looks like that vine may be dying. However, the vine itself is still green. See, there's one right there. I think I showed that one. Like I said, I'm not going to bother it. Lucy, I thought you were supposed to go with Mommy. Yeah, there's about 10 of these at least out here. Come on, Lucy. I'm trying to step on the flowers or the vines. These are black-eyed peas, too. I took a bunch, probably about six, four or five, yesterday or the day before yesterday, and opened them. And they're black-eyed peas, and I see like what looks like a wasp was just on that little flower right there. And that's fine. Like I said, I spread them out, I guess. I mixed them up. But yeah, I'd rather have more than not enough variety, too. See, that I was under the impression was Trail of Tears. There's three down there, and I believe there's three. Yeah, there's three stems down there. This is where I planted the Trail of Tears beans. And I'm not gonna pull them off while I'm videoing because I tried it before and it messes up. It's just too difficult. See, look at the fresh leaves coming out on that. You see insects on here, but then you see the fresh leaves coming out. So it wants to survive. See that butterfly? I can't see on the video on the screen. Big yellow, not real big, but bigger than that. Anyway, leave those alone. See, it's another example. Dies off. Like, I keep feeding it, I give it the liquid fertilizer, and it starts coming back a little bit. I try spraying a little bit. See the insects damage on it? See, I got this little sprinkler that's around here for like 40 minutes at night, every 2 days, 3 days this time. I got holes now on the plastic like I should have. Bell pepper, insect damage. Norwegian bean, insect damage. I believe Norwegian bean on this one, I'm not positive, but I think. But look at the insect damage on that. That's a cucumber. Do you see this little cucumber on here? Yeah, it's a little pickle on here. Two of them. Let me see it. Let me see if I can zoom in on it. See, I gotta zoom in and zoom out for it to focus a little bit better. Right in the center, that long thing is a cucumber. Naked eye, I can see it. There's two little cucumbers on here, little babies. Baby. Oh wow. Thank you, Monsanto, you fucking piece of shit, garbage, poisonous crop. Thank you, man, God, for controlling the fucking weather. Thank you, Fukushima, for the radiation. Thank you. Yucky. Hey, it's life. Unedited, uncut. Yeah, it's going to be a lot different. That's going to be a walkway where this one is here. We're going to go up that way. We're going to have a walkway there. Maybe not as wide, but close about where that. Oh, I forgot those. Did you see the beach? Oh, okay. Huh. I didn't record them yesterday. I didn't record, but you see down there, I had put two beet seeds in each of these little holes. I got three growing there. Put two seeds there. Looks like three or four growing there. I put two seeds here. I got two or three here. See, that's how I put them down. These leaves really drive me crazy because of the diseases from the trees. But these are beets. All them green leaves with these diseased fucking leaves. Yeah, like I can do anything to change them. Look at this. See, this is what my aggravation is with this stuff. I can't record while I'm doing something. Beets. All heirloom. Yeah, see how the leaves. Okay, I'm going to go over here and rake these leaves. I'm going to use them when I do my sunflower wall again. Like this time, I had about six or eight sunflower right up on the garden. They grew from last year. I didn't plant them. They just grew from last year. So I left them until about a week ago, and I just knocked them down. But this wall right here, I call it, is going to go back there where you see that dead grass. That's about another 15 feet back. So I'm going to measure it, and I'm going to try doing this with the tiller. Before I do the tiller, I'm going to put stakes and string. This time I'm going to do it as correctly as possible so that it's even. I'm going to be at least 25 feet, I think, off of the plastic for the garden. And I'm going to go that way. I'm going further back. You can see, actually, it's about 4 feet deeper than I cut with the lawnmower. I'm going to take the tiller and do that, and I'm going to go around to the very where the hill just comes down to the lawn over here. So, right about where that shade ends is about how far back it's going to go. That's about 12 feet back on this side. So, and then go down all the way that way. But as straight as possible, like I said, I'll put a stake over there, and one over there with a string on them, and we'll mark it, and we'll do the same thing about 4 feet this side of it, coming back this way, going that way, and then like I said, 4 feet across this way, and down at the end down there. So we'll have a giant U with assorted sunflowers again. And anybody know what these are right here? Again, my ignorance, because I mean, well, just trust me. I tried looking up different things and not successful. But I don't know if anybody knows what these are. The way they're plant, the way they're growing, I think of them as being something from the heirloom family, because I bought seeds for different heirloom flowers that were had medicinal purposes. See, that's a little torch sunflower down there. It's just stunted growth because they weren't coming out, and I planted a few of them after the fact. So I wanted stuff like that right there throughout the thing. See, one there. Some of them did come up, not many though. And now the smaller ones are coming up. So it'd be like that, but it'd be further back, all the way down. And it'll be about 15 to 20 feet on down that on the other side there. All those are going to be torn down probably this next day or two. It's going to be around mid-upper 80s. And at night in the low 70s. See, I believe this is, oh, God bless it. My wife told me what these were. But there's a poisonous version of this and this one, if I'm not mistaken. I could be wrong, though. I think this may not be the one I'm thinking of. But, see, this is one of the flowers I planted, you know, from the seeds I had gotten. I ordered a bunch of seeds from Heirloom Solutions. And, you know, they grew. I've knocked down, by the way, you know, this is just blank because I've broken off a lot of these. See the dead sunflowers here? Sunflowers have their life expectancy. But, again, we have Monsanto cotton about 50 feet. If it's that, I don't think it's 50 feet. It's probably about 30 feet away from this garden. And when they spray, which they do at the beginning every week, they haven't sprayed for about 2 to 3 weeks now, but every week they spray with the most toxic poisons to kill off any insects to get their imitation cotton. Because, folks, it's imitation. It's genetically modified, okay? God, get your head out of your ass. This is right up on top of it, though, on top of us. This is about 40 feet around us. That back there is further, but still. You see how close it is to this garden. That's the reason I wanted these sunflowers and all these other flowers right here. They did okay, but, I mean, they died off. And, again, I blame it on that. I blame it on Monsanto. I blame it on the man-manufactured weather. And I blame it on Fukushima. And, I mean, just what else can I do? What is it of my fault? You know, I mean, what? Look at all the greenery all around them. Why are those dead? Why are they dead? Oh, yeah, they probably got something into them from, I don't know, a spray of some sort. So, yeah, we're back to the tomatoes. The tomatoes are going to be up front, and they're not going to have nearly as many as we have out here right now. And I wanted more than this, even. But you see the worms that we have out here. It's a long video, I know, but I just try to put as much in there as I can. And I do it on the fly. I don't have a planned out agenda of doing this, and then that, and then this is one. I just say, this is what happened, then I go to here, and I'm so forth. So we have a few tomato plants that look somewhat, on 1 to 10 being healthy, they're about 75, 7.5. But, you know, the majority of them are like looking like that right there. And that one there. So, damn it to hell. I got to get a rake and rake up these leaves so I can use them for compost where I'm going to put my sunflower wind fence. So we've got the yellow butterflies out here, and you saw that black one, so there are butterflies still around here. And that bee, which really kind of shocked me, I mean, it is November only, but still, I mean November, September. See your oak right now? That's about 9 feet tall, 8 feet tall. That one might be 9 foot. That one right there, that red one might be 9 foot. So, looks like trees, don't they? Have to use a saw to cut those, get the plastic folded up to till it and put some horse manure down here. We'll put the soil on top of it, mix it in. It's gonna smell out here, it's gonna smell out here, it's gonna smell out here. Oh, there's a bee right there. They're going in that flower. I don't know if you can see it. Focus, focus. There, see him. Come on. There's a bee right there. So we do have bees. I see some small ones out here too. So there are bees out here yet, which is a good thing since we have the flowers on, the blooms on a lot of these plants. My hummingbird up there, two of them. We got a hummingbird feeder right there too, if I can get through the... Anyway, all right, let me get over here and start raking these leaves so that this can be mowed as it dries. I'm gonna shut off the camera and put it over here. Gotta move that into the sun too. Look at my grill. I've used it like 4 or 5 times. Thought I was gonna do a lot more, but people don't realize, like I said, there are a lot of people don't realize, it gets windy out here. In the morning like this, it's kind of somewhat calm. Later in the day, you'll see this stuff swaying. It has nothing to do with man-made weather modification with the spraying and all. I think it was like killed the skies technically. So there you go. I put this down here on this table.